Good morning, and thank you for joining us today on Tenable Cyber Watch, cyber news you can use. I'm your host, Jirah Mickle. Well, today is Monday, February 13th, and we're just officially one day away from Valentine's Day. So, as we continue in the spirit of the month of love, here's another little poem. Roses are red, violets are blue. Here are four new cybersecurity topics that should matter to you. Watch, we're talking about the new NIST framework for artificial intelligence risk management. And next, how organizations are balancing AI and data privacy, plus how employee money transfer scams are on the upswing. And later, top tips on how to improve business security communications for security leaders. Tenable Cyber Watch starts right now. U.S. government issued a new framework for securing artificial intelligence. The U.S. government is concerned that makers and users of AI systems may lack guidance about the risks and dangers associated with AI products. These risks associated with AI products include their vulnerability to be easily manipulated by algorithms and influenced by arbitrary societal dynamics. The AI risk management framework released by NIST comes as a guidance to create awareness about AI's unique risk and help systems designers, developers, and users address and manage AI risk via flexible, structured, and measurable processes. The framework is expected to be revised by NIST periodically. NIST will also launch the Trustworthy and Responsible AI Resource Center to assist organizations in putting the framework into practice. And how are organizations managing to balance AI and data privacy? Well, a new study by the International Association of Privacy Professionals looked at organizations' maturity level in using AI responsibly and securely in its Privacy and AI Governance Report. The report surveyed an undisclosed number of privacy, policy, legal, and technical AI experts in North America, Europe, and Asia, and found the following. 70% of organizations surveyed are at some point in the process of including responsible AI in their governance. Half of organizations are building responsible AI governance on top of existing mature privacy programs, and that overall, it's a struggle for organizations to find and acquire appropriate tools to address responsible AI, such as tools for detecting bias in AI applications. The report also recommends that to advance responsible AI, organizations should focus on gaining leadership support, championing ethical uses of data, growing and improving training on the use of AI, and implementing AI ethics in the same way as privacy by design and default. Employees beware because money transfer scams are on the rise. 2022 saw an increase in money transfer scams for employees. That's according to the Beasley Group's latest cyber services snapshot. These cyber scams involve employees getting duped into transferring money to a cyber thief. The report states that fraudulent instruction scams went up 13% compared with 2021, highlighting the importance of cybersecurity awareness training in the workplaces. The Beasley Group also predicts threat actors will continue pursuing this type of attack aggressively in 2023. It recommends organizations better educate employees about cyber fraud tactics, such as spoofed emails, establish processes for verifying payment requests, enhance login practices, and invest in identity and access management. and security leaders, are you looking for ways to improve business security communications? Ian's research released a new blog titled Tips for Effective Negotiations with Leadership, with recommendations for security leaders who want to communicate better with their business counterparts. Those tips include, number one, security leaders speaking about the underlying strategies behind policies and how they serve as avenues to accomplish business goals. Number two, understanding the business needs behind the issues being discussed and aligning security issues to broader business goals to show that you're both rowing in the same direction and with the same purpose. And number three, highlighting how security controls and capabilities can generate a competitive advantage for the business, such as putting the organization on better footing for deals that require specific security certifications or compliance with regulations. And well, that rounds up our cybersecurity snapshot for the week of February 13th. For more insights and details from the snapshot, you can visit us online at tenable.com. See you all next week for more cyber news you can use. I'm Jirah Mickle. Thank you for tuning in. And from all of us here at Tenable, have a lovely day and happy Valentine's Day.